Christmas, the celebration that recognizes the birth of Jesus Christ, who was the Savior of the world and who came to die for the sins of you and I. Christmas is a wonderful holiday which had its origins in the early church in Roman culture, creating a holiday that would be celebrating Christ's birth and started in 336 AD. But at the same time, even though Christmas is considered to be a Christian holiday, it is also has some pagan infiltration in this holiday and has had it for hundreds and thousands of years. So the question is, should Christians who celebrate the birth of Christ based on the accounts of the Gospels, which had the shepherds, the angels, and the wise men, and of course the mother and father of Jesus, celebrate the birth of Christ, should Christians be celebrating this holiday? And I want to talk to you about this and help you see the truth regarding this holiday and how we can honor God through it without getting muddled up in all of the traditions of men and traditions of paganism that surrounded it. So Christmas began, as I mentioned, in 336 AD in the Roman Empire. This was a little after the Roman Empire decriminalized Christianity and made Christianity the state religion under the Emperor Constantine. Now, the Emperor Constantine was not necessarily a true born-again Christian. There was a lot of debate about him and who he really was. And there's truth to the fact that he institutionalized Christianity and combined it with the Roman culture and government because that was the way to gain power, because a lot of people in the Roman Empire were becoming Christians over the three centuries that Christianity was being spread after the death and resurrection of Christ. But during the time of that Christmas became a holiday and was instituted December 25th, there was also two other pagan celebrations that were happening. Many people believe to this day, based on history, that the church chose the 25th of December to counteract the influence of honoring the sun god on Christmas, which was the day of the unconquerable sun, which was a very pagan holiday, worshiping the son of God, not S-O-N, but the S-U-N. And even till this point today, everyone still argues about this. And there was other holidays too. There's a Jewish Hanukkah, which was during that season and still is in December. There's a German Yule. There's that, like I mentioned, the day of the unconquered sun. And some people think that the Christians chose it, or the early church chose it, because it would Christianize those pagan holidays. But most of it was, because there is truth to that, it was actually done in order to celebrate the birth of Christ and to also Christianize the Roman Empire, of course. But it doesn't mean that Christmas was an answer to Saturnalia. So it wasn't necessarily replacing those holidays, but there was truth to the fact that Christmas was moved to that date. And there were also early church fathers that did think that Christ was conceived in March based on the Jewish calendar, and then he was born on the 25th of December. So there was some calculations that went into that, which also created the event of Christmas on the 25th. But again, the truth is that no one really knows when Christ was born. No, it's not really even that important the date he was born. Some people say it was September or late August, because the shepherds would not be leaving their sheep overnight or tending them overnight in such a cold weather. And I agree, that wasn't a common practice back then and today, that people would tend their sheep in such freezing weather. So it makes sense that the date of Christ's birth could have been a different date. But nonetheless, the Western and Eastern Church then kept Christmas as a holiday for Christianity and Christendom. And so the Western Church kept it for 25th of December, the Eastern Church kept it for 6th of January. And so that became the Christmas celebration of today. But when it comes to Christmas, is it actually the same as Halloween? The thing is that Halloween is evil in origin, and its current usage of darkness and death makes it part of the kingdom of darkness. And a lot of things that have origins are not necessarily bad today, because the Thursday is Thor's day and Sunday is the day of the sun. But we as Christians, or people around the world, we don't worship Thor. We don't worship the sun god. We don't celebrate the day of the unconquerable sun either. So the thing is that just because it parallels something, or because the root of it was pagan, and then over thousands of years it lost its meaning completely, does not mean that you just stop living on Thursday or living on Sunday or living on any other day. So that's why we have to be careful with association, because there's a lot of things you can associate, not necessarily the case. It's like similar with the origin of the swastika. So the swastika was a symbol that German Reich used in World War II. It's the cross that shaped bent like that. But the swastika originally meant as a symbol of peace. But now if anyone put a swastika on their front door to celebrate peace, that would be considered nuts and crazy, and considered to be Hitler's Nazi supporters. So the thing is that we have to use wisdom when we celebrate holidays or use certain things or do certain things that were considered to be meaning something differently back then than they are today. So Christmas wasn't necessarily a pagan holiday originally. It was really about the celebration of Christ. It is based off the word Christ Mass, which is the communion of Christ, or celebration with others based on the birth of Christ. It is a biblical thing, because in the Gospel of Matthew and Luke, that was the birth of Christ, and it was written out of the importance of knowing that Jesus Christ was born of a virgin. That was the core doctrinal issue of Christianity, that he was God in human form and that he came to earth as a baby. So Christmas, in the Christian sense, without even the institutionalizing it of it by Constantine or the Roman Catholic Church, is actually a Christian holiday in its root, because it's based off the biblical gospels, which talk about the birth of Christ, and then the angels and the shepherds celebrated it. And Israel was also looking for the coming of the Messiah, so that's why it was such a celebrated event when Christ was born. And just like we celebrate our birthdays, there's nothing wrong with celebrating Christ's birth, since most of us borrow this tradition of celebrating our birthdays, and most of us don't even know where that came from. Why would it be wrong to celebrate the birth of Christ? And in true honesty, we should be celebrating Christ's birth, death and resurrection every day, because when we give our lives to Christ and we become followers of his, every day we should be celebrating Christ and what he's done in our lives. So Christmas doesn't even have to be a one day event, it could be an everyday event. So the thing is about celebrating Christmas is that it's important to understand that you got to follow your convictions as a Christian and follow your conscience. And Romans chapter 14, 5 through 8, it says that it's up to individual conscience, or what you convince in your heart, to whether to celebrate or to eat certain days or foods, but don't let it become such an issue where it separates people from the body of Christ. And then 1 Corinthians 10:31 says, whatever you do, it for the glory of God. So it's important to listen to God's Spirit telling you what God wants you to do on Christmas Day. And the thing is that if people say Christmas is a pagan holiday because there's traditions that are pagan that have been added onto it over hundreds of years, or that Christians repackaged it, then that's fine. Don't put up trees or ornaments or other things on Christmas. That it should be up to your conscience. But you can also share the gospel on Christmas or have a nativity scene up at your house, or to at least remember the birth of Christ in some way. So that's why it's important to understand that if we truly love Christ, if we truly love the people of God, then we shouldn't be telling that somebody is sinning because they're celebrating Christmas a certain way, or we shouldn't either. And it doesn't mean that we agree with Santa Claus, or I agree with Santa Claus. Of course, that's what Santa Claus is today. It's a fake entity, because Santa Claus doesn't give gifts, and he doesn't know who's naughty or nice, or has godlike powers to know what everybody's doing around the world. Of course, Santa is a made-up concept in America, but it is also based on a real character, which I will get into shortly. I want to switch to the idea of Christmas around the world, like how the world that's not Christian celebrates Christmas. The thing is, everyone celebrates Christmas, maybe not Jews, but some of them do. Some of the people still gather together and eat food and celebrate, and people from different backgrounds celebrate Christmas because it's become very commercialized. And the thing is, we shouldn't celebrate Christmas based on what the world celebrates Christmas about. Now, that's something that I truly believe that God wants to convict our hearts on, is to not make Christmas like what the world makes Christmas, because what the world makes Christmas about is to party, to drink, to overeat, to spend insane amounts of money, or just become materialistic on this holiday. it becomes a pressurized, a pressure cooker, a pressurized holiday and time of season where it's all buy, sell, and it doesn't really become about give or to thank God for the birth of Jesus Christ, because the world is not concerned about who Jesus is or how he's calling us to repent of our sin and put our faith in him on Christmas. The world's not really thinking about that. But as Christians, if we lift up Christ and we do it in the right way, then it's not a sin to celebrate Christmas or to celebrate Christmas or to not celebrate Christmas, because we're lifting Christ up during this holiday season anyways. But again, like I said, if it's a personal conscience issue and you feel like it is a sin for you, then don't do it, because the Bible says whatever our conscience doesn't approve of is sin to us individually. So it's important to know what your conscience says. But also, I want to say, be careful of legalism, because that can also keep us from enjoying the good things during Christmas, like getting together with friends and family, giving gifts to one another, which Jesus even said it's better to give than to receive. And what better way, season of doing that, than on Christmas? It's actually a great way of showing Christmas cheer and God's love to others, because people go through a very hard time during Christmas. I've known that Christmas and the holidays are actually can be very depressing to a lot of people, because they don't have family, they don't have friends. They went through a lot of difficulty, lost their jobs. They lost somebody in their families. It could be a very difficult time for somebody, and you can use Christmas, the day, the holiday, the season, to really bless others. That's why Christmas has become such a tradition where Christians celebrate it, and they don't actually worship a tree or bow down to ornaments or the German Yule or whatever is added on to Christmas. And people also cite Jeremiah 10, because they say that in Jeremiah chapter 10, there's verses about cutting down a tree and then making it into an idol and bowing down before it. And so a lot of people say that's a sin. We shouldn't be having a Christmas tree, because that means that you're going against Jeremiah 10 and bowing down to it. But again, as a Christian, has been a Christian for a long time, I have never bowed down to a tree, even though I've been with friends with Christmas trees. I've had a Christmas tree. I've never seen anyone bow down to it or worship it. Now, if they did that, I would be totally against that, of course, because that is definitely idolatry. But so even though the Christmas tree itself comes from hundreds of years of traditions, there is some traditions where it comes from paganism, but there's also tradition where it comes from Martin Luther, who brought a tree into his house for his family to celebrate the light of Jesus Christ or the birth of Christ, and then he put ornaments on the tree. So there's these different contradictory traditions of where the Christmas tree comes from. But in reality, again, it's an issue of the conscience. The thing is, if you don't want to add any of these things onto your Christmas celebration, you want to just make it about Christ or the nativity scene, then that's perfectly fine, because if that causes you an issue with your conscience, then don't do it. Another thing about Christmas is the addition of Santa Claus. Now, I mentioned that the concept of Santa Claus it basically became a very American thing, even though the reality of who Santa Claus was, or Saint Nicholas, was it comes from hundreds of years ago from a Dutch tradition called Sinterklaas. And it was based on a real man called Saint Nicholas. Again, he was part of the Catholic Church, so take that as you may. I'm not Catholic, so I don't agree with the Catholic Church. But the thing is, he was somebody, a Christian in the early Christian history, who helped the poor, and he was known for Christian generosity. He was also a bishop of the Church of Asia Minor, and he was also persecuted for his Christian beliefs, because this was in the early 4th century, mid 4th century in the Roman Empire. And so he was released by Constantine, and then also attended the Council of Nicaea, where, contrary to popular opinion, it wasn't about deciding which books go into the Bible. That was already known, but it was the debate about the divinity of Christ and who Christ really was. So anyway, so Saint Nicholas does have basis in who a real man who was actually a Christian and actually did a lot of things to spread the gospel. But that's not what it is today. So I'm not saying to celebrate Santa Claus today, because he's definitely a fake entity and he's not a real person. And today Santa Claus is actually based on the late 19th century creation of Coca-Cola, because they designed Santa Claus the way he is designed today. That's why you see a lot of commercials about Santa Claus from Coca-Cola. And I didn't know that before, but when I found out about that, I was like, wow, this is amazing. It definitely became very commercialized and very materialistic, because Santa became known as somebody who's going to just give you gifts and decide whether you've been naughty or nice. And then kids get told lies from an early age, like I was in Ukraine, former Soviet Union. It was a little different celebration. But even when I was a little younger and I came to America, I was also told about Santa. I believe he was real. But then I found out he wasn't. Now, it didn't break my heart or shock me. But I grew out of it, of course, like everyone does. But I do believe it's wrong to tell people that Santa is real, because it's obviously not. He's not going to give you gifts. It's your parents that do that, or your friends or family. So in that sense, celebrating Santa on Christmas is definitely not right, because, I mean, it's not wrong to dress up as Santa to spread the gospel. That's fine, because the culture uses it. But to teach kids Santa Claus and that he's real and lie to them and then tell them, oh, wait, I just lied to you, he doesn't exist, then that makes people question everything. Because if their parents teach them Santa Claus isn't real, then what if the devil puts the ideas he has? Is God real? Is Easter Bunny not real? Is anything real? So the thing is that we have to be really careful to not become like the world itself, where we tell people nice little lies because it's Christmas or because it's been done throughout a few hundred years. So in conclusion, Christmas is originally an event about the birth of Christ. It is a very special event. The thing is, it's important is to take the worldliness out of Christmas or Christ's celebration. We must remember that God came down as a human baby in human form, and he died on the cross for our sins. That Christmas was the most amazing day next to Easter, because it was the day that God invaded our universe and he actually split time in half, because now we have BC and AD because of the birth of Christ, which is based on the birth of Christ. And so that's why Christmas, in its origin, its root, is a celebration about who Jesus Christ was and how he came to die for us. But also, Christmas does have pagan history as well. So if you're celebrating Christ, then do that on Christmas. But if you think it's pagan, then don't do it. But again, be careful judging other Christians and becoming prideful and telling everybody else that they're sinning because they're celebrating Christmas in a different way than you seem fit. As long as we know Jesus Christ as our personal Lord and Savior, as long as we have repented of our sin and put our faith in Christ, then all these other issues are secondary issues and they're not salvation issues. And God will make things clear to us, because he'll reveal to us all truth. If you want to know truth about Christmas, do your research. Understand that there's Christian history and pagan history behind it, but also understand that celebrating the birth of Christ on the 25th is not a sin and it's not wrong. I would encourage everybody, if you are celebrating Christmas, tell someone about Jesus on Christmas Day. Make it truly about Jesus, because then you can tell and ask people, what is the real meaning of Christmas? And then you can tell them the gospel. And that's what I have been doing with me and my friends for the month of December. We have been telling people about Jesus almost every single day, and we're gonna do that on Christmas Day as well. So God bless you guys. And if you enjoyed this message, leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more of these kind of commentaries, and leave your thoughts and tell me, what do you think about Christmas? Do you think it's pagan? Do you think it's Christian? Do you think it's both? And let me know your thoughts, and I'd love to hear what you think. God bless you.